It seems to be more and more noticed that a couple of firms, Facebook and Alphabet, Google in particular, are really dominating in their particular segment of using social media and the internet, these disruptive innovations, these new cultural forces influencing our politics with Facebook's news feed and things like that. What is grabbing people's attention, I think, is their sort of monopoly position. A recent story in the Wall Street Journal, again, newspaper stories almost every day are giving us hard facts, real events, which allow us to think about the principles of moral capitalism being applied or not being applied. But in any case, a few days ago, Facebook announced that its profit rose a better than expected 71%. Now, everybody ought to step back and think, if you can raise your profit by 71% in a short period, what's going on? Do you really have a better way of slicing bread? Do you have some sort of quasi-monopoly position? Is it just a fluke? Did the price of oil go down or up, which helps you in the short run? What's going on? Well, it turns out that Facebook, along with Alphabet's Google, soaked up 99% of the online ad industry's growth in 2016. 99% leaves 1% for everybody else. I would say 99% split two ways is a virtual monopoly, a small cartel, well, it's not a cartel, we don't know if they agree with each other, but you can surely watch what the other guy is doing to do your own pricing and placing and stuff like this. But it's clearly an oligopoly of just two firms. What are the consequences of this? If they drive out competition, where's the next generation of innovators going to come from? If they are charging monopoly prices because of the lack of competition, then they're extracting what the economists call rents from the economy, taking money away from more than they sort of deserve in terms of the quality of their product, taking money away from other alternative uses. Other products, you could buy more clothes for your kids, you could invest in the stock market, you could do this, you could that, but you can't because your money is being sucked up via the advertising revenue that goes to Google and Facebook. Those advertisers, by the way, if there were more competition, could spread that money around. So one of the issues which seems to be emerging more and more around our work in moral capitalism is structure. The power structure of market segments, of big firms like Google and Facebook, and the relationship between government policy and structure. Is the antitrust policy being enforced? Should it be? Is it not? Is deregulation, does that help a few firms tend to have a dominant position, or do they get there because their products and services are truly competitive and more appreciated by customers? I think it's important to pay attention to structure, because in the past, that's also a way to intervene when too much power is held by too few people.